What am I? You made me this way. I'm a full-blooded combat soldier. Just don't turn it off.
Talk to me, Johnny.
You just don't turn it off! It's over!
Invaded Afghanistan to fight the war against evil. And that was really a new concept, and we wanted to understand it. And that's why we started to do a series of performance lectures called the Rambo Lectures, because we were using the film Rambo 3 as our main frame of reference. Rambo 3 is set in Afghanistan. Rambo goes to Afghanistan to fight with the freedom fighters, the courageous Mujahideen, who are very fierce people. They are actually the precursors of the Taliban, but they fight the evil Soviets, so back then they're very good people.
Oh. One thing we started to understand was, and not only us, it was a public concept, or people started to think about it, was war became asymmetric. It was not any longer nations declaring war to other nations. It was the United States. The United States going to Afghanistan fighting terrorists, fighting evil. So war became smaller and smaller and smaller. Strange things were fighting each other.
Like where before maybe one country had been fighting another country, now one country was fighting a moral concept, evil. So the movie was quite helpful in understanding all this. But it was still, it took a strange turn along the road. It became sort of cabaret. We were like telling leftist audiences what they wanted to hear, and they would laugh about it, and we would all have a good time. So it was completely pointless in a way. The people we were criticizing or the critical thinking we were doing were not going where it was supposed to go. And so we're not doing that kind of performances anymore. We stopped quite a long time ago. And we do different stuff now, no more lectures. But a lot of things have changed since then, also in the political arena. Most of all, in 2008, Sylvester Stallone finally made Rambo 4. We always thought we had to make it for him because he wasn't doing it in 2001, but now 2008 he made John Rambo.
He made John Rambo with a strange consequence. In the end of John Rambo, fourth part of the legendary series, John Rambo goes finally home. That's where part one started. He goes home to the farm of his father and he vanishes. Smaller and smaller black spot in the end of it. And he's really gone. And this is why we can't stop, because there's another very important person that's apparently gone.
And that's, of course, Osama bin Laden. Back then in 2001, war was already fragmented. It was going through all kinds of parts of our lives, but there were still sort of these ancient hero figures we could attach them to. The evil guy was Osama bin Laden. The other evil guy was George W. Bush. The only good guy around was John Rambo. Now, with John Rambo gone home, he doesn't have war in himself anymore. And with Osama, supposedly dead, I mean, what did they show us? They showed us a video of an old guy watching TV. And they showed us a photo of the President of the United States also watching TV, supposedly watching on TV how the other bad guy is being killed. But we don't know. They didn't show us the image because supposedly there was brain matter coming out of Bin Laden's eyes, and that was have been too cruel to show to the audience, to the public. So we never got to see any of that. But they're gone. Like these people are sort of trickling out. Good, we don't have this hero image to sort of still follow him.
So you see, some things changed since 10 years ago, but there's one thing that didn't change. It's still a war going on.
All right. Get to get down to this. Please, everyone,
pass it on.
Take one, pass
take
it on.
Pass it on.
And take one, pass it on, and move it. We don't have a lot of time.
Yeah.
We have a lot more performances.
That's what Henrik told us before. We told you a war is going on. I tell you it's pork fighting Google.
And Google is at war with Mercedes-Benz.
Mercedes-Benz is at war with supermarket.
And the supermarket is at war with the rainforest.
The rainforest is at war with garbage. And if you have garbage there, then please raise
okay,
your hand.
Who's garbage?
Let's
see. No,
who's
hold,
garbage?
Raise up the cards. Let's see the cards. Where's the garbage? And the garbage is at war with heroin. Where's the heroin? Come on, let's see the heroin.
Heroin
spread out all over the world.
Heroin is at war with the beard.
Where's the beard?
Beard. Who's got the beard? Let's see your hands. Who's got the beard? Whose
beard? Beard is at war with money. Where's money? A lot of money going down.
There's money. It's all wars. Money is at war. Money is at war with pork. Who's got pork? Let me see your hands.
Pork
Who's
is at pork? War with...
Where's pork?
Pork is at war with oil.
Oh, oil, there we got hands, loads of hands with oil. Oil is at war with money.
And money is at war with heroin.
Heroin is at war with pork. Believe me, heroin with pork, war, yes.
And pork is at war with this supermarket.
We have the supermarket hand, supermarket is at...
What else are you at war with?
Google.
What else are you at war with?
Supermarket.
Mercedes.
Rainforest.
Yeah, rainforest.
Mercedes at war with
other things, not our things. What are
Come
your
on,
things? What are you at war
be
with?
Be quick, be quick. There's lots
Come
of
on.
Wars
what
going
is
on.
Enough of reason. What?
Garbage.
Garbage.
Garbage
at war.
Is at war with
pork.
Money.
Pork. I want to have the pork. What
money.
About tourists? There
tourists.
Must be some tourists.
Where
tourists.
Are the tourists? The tourists are at war.
Tourists.
With
religion.
Religion. The religion is at war with
music.
Love.
Nuclear power.
Nuclear
power.
Power.
Where's nuclear power? Please. War Point. Of nuclear power with
Japan.
Tourists.
Banks also.
Banks.
Money.
Are at war with money.
No.
Nuclear families.
Nuclear families are at war with nuclear power.
Thank you.
every time I call my mom on the phone, I'm at war.
I like it.
Every time I travel, I'm at war.
I like it.
Every time I shop, I'm at war.
I like it.
When I go to work, I go to war.
I like it.
When I fall in love, I'm at war. The sun comes up in the morning, it is at war. Every time I go online, I go to war. Thank you. Waffe muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein. In jedem Apfel muss ein Ei sein. In jedem Ei muss ein Apfel sein.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Jan. Anyone would like to add a comment or a question or say something? I'm personally not quite sure I understood the ending.
Yeah, that's what it's about.
I'm personally happy about the question. It's like the question for us was like, after politics comes there esoteric behavior, something like that. And maybe you want to comment on this.
Well, I think when we look at what's going on in the world with industrialism, capitalism, banks going crazy, wars still going on, imperialism still going on, we can sort of clearly see that the concepts of humanism and rationalism have failed. They went out in the 17th century and promised us a better world, a world that would be more equal and better for everyone involved. This has obviously not worked. So what we are trying to do is develop methods of criticism that rely on different ways of speaking. And of course, being people of the 20th century, not the 21st maybe, not me, we are not familiar with those ways of speaking anymore. We have to reinvent them unless we want to go back to ancient forms of other religions that already exist and that are obviously a part of that thing going down. So we have to reinvent another way of speaking, and I believe that is quite seriously, in spite of all the fun we're having here tonight, quite seriously, if there is any reason to make art anymore, that's the reason to try and find those kind of languages, that kind of different speaking.
Well, that's the broadsword, I think. One thing we were looking for, okay, we had like this one thing about the wars, where did the war go, and if you take it like seriously, like what like most European countries and nations are about is that we have to change something, the environment and nuclear power and all these things, but then like on the other hand, like it's small changes all the time and nobody, and everybody is like very aware of like the heavy consequences of the Western lifestyles and things, but like at the same time, it's like only like very small changes and this reality, this utter reality of like being actually at war all the time. That like war before was like a certain kind of like social event, very much apart from like all sorts of like other kinds of like social events. And that it now turned around, like that every social event sort of means to be at war, or is at least a hostile action. that this reality, you can't get out of it. You can't really choose sides. Like, you have to like break the cycle and get out of it. And obviously, and of course, we don't have an answer like how to do this. But that's somehow like what we are at in this work in progress.
What's the potential of the Rambo figure?
Well, with this work, we're sort of getting past the Rambo figure. When we worked about the subjects very much 10 years ago, it helped us sort of to, it was an embodiment. Looking at these old movies, we sort of understood how the definition of good and evil worked. Like the really fun part of watching Rambo 3 that was made in the 80s, again after 2001, was that the entire moral, the political moral, was completely backwards. Like the Islamic fighters were the good guys just because they were fighting the Soviets. And so in this movie, besides all these cool fighting scenes and explosions and all this stuff that you usually watch Rambo movies for, you have like the CIA guy and the army guy and the politicians sort of explaining why the Mujahideen are really cool guys. Not only because they're fighting the Soviets, but because they are so strong in their faith and all that. And sort of to read the news of 2001 and 2002 when we did this series through this movie sort of helped us put it into perspective. Like, this way we are removed. We always think we're like in the middle of things because we have the internet and all. But actually, we are fed a lot of stuff, and
some really weird things happened at that time. There was like Spiegel, German news magazine, who suddenly used movie stills from Rambo to explain this is the Taliban, this is how they meet together. But it was like movie stills they used as documentary footage. And then there was the other thing, that there was certain like 80s things, but like when Rambo is talking to Troutman and Troutman telling, hey, I made you and you are war, that they created actually like a figure, a person who is not human any longer, but it incorporated war to overcome war. And that seemed to be like a way how to counter-read US American strategies at that time. Like, how evil have you got to become yourself in order to fight evil, and how long can you control that evil before you yourself become completely evil? And this is where, like, then again, like, there was this other figure, Ripley. This is the other movies, like, I mean, yeah, we watched a lot, was the Alien movies, and then there's like she's slowly progressing, but in the end she's like a clone and cloned the alien queen into herself directly, and where she can't really decide, like, am I like alien, or how long can I control and fight on the side of the humans to fight the alien, which then becomes more and more human itself.
And there's actually this always these scenes of in the Rambo movies where Rambo is suffering from having this war inside him, like a disease. So actually, even a movie like the Rambo movies was more complex than the official politics of the USA at that time, which only knew good and evil, and one side was totally good and the other side was totally evil.
And now it's this, like, he was like still suffering, but I think this is like actually like, and he was avant-garde, like having the war in himself, but like nowadays, like in Western European countries, we are fighting this war all the time, and the reaction is like that we like things or we dislike things, and thus like Facebook somehow, like the strategies of Facebook becomes the new theater of war. And Rambo was living through this in the 80s already. And so it's like this weird dead end.
Well, the fascinating part is that this fragmentation has really reached a point where it can't go much further. But we're like in this preaching mode again, do you know this? Like we did in the... Maybe somebody has a question.
Questions, anyone, or comments?
But is the German male the like the savior here?
Oh, because please?
Yeah, and like, I mean, like, you represent some kind of
sure.
No, it's really an attractive thought, kind of, right?
You answer.
I didn't choose to be German.
But you choose that we should wear these.
I thought it looks
sexy and slightly.
It does.
Yeah, I think that's a lot of what we aim for, sort of this combination of being sexy and slightly ridiculous.
Ridiculously sexy.
German man, maybe you could see it like that.
We've got this, like, I think it's like really strange, you know, like Ripley is gone, John Rambo is gone, and we sort of like imagine them in this like 70s psychedelia cave where they are circling around each other and dreaming the new wars, which are not really wars, but at the same time, like, you know, like this weird esoteric thing. And we were looking for something that goes pretty much the opposite, which is then like,
This evilness and non-evilness. I mean, this spinning in the end is sort of it's a very small impression of this 10,000-year meditation that Ripley and Rambo would do in the cave before they sort of transform war and evil that live inside them into something completely different.
Good. Thanks. I know you both can continue talking for the rest of the evening, and you probably will at the bar later on. So. Any last questions or any last comments? Otherwise, Jørgen Huyen, as Søren Dahlgaard, will be here. So go ask them, have a beer, buy them a drink, or buy me a drink. And now we'll take a small break. Thank you both. And after the break, it will be Stuart Lynch.
Det var det, jeg siger, mig og Anne var sådan, vi havde mødt dem.